thanks for joining us here on the web. An early morning argument in Farmington has left one man in the hospital and another charged with attempted murder. Farmington police say Nathan Foster shot the man and then left the home, but has since turned himself in. WMUR's Ray Brewer has the story.
20-year-old Nathan Foster is charged with attempted murder. Around 12:20 Monday morning, according to Farmington police, at 154 Ridge Road, Foster shot another man. Police say the shooting happened at close range with a small caliber handgun.
It was upper chest area near the shoulder, and like I say, I would expect a recovery.
The Farmington police chief says that both men knew each other, although it's unclear if they were both living at the house. But prior to the shooting, there was an argument.
What was the argument about, Chief?
We're still under investigation for it.
On the kitchen table, there was what appeared to be drug paraphernalia, but the chief says at this point they can't say if drugs were involved.
There is some evidence that the officers did observe that we want to be able to properly document and obtain.
The 911 call was made by someone inside the house, according to the chief, although at this point in time, police aren't saying how many people were home. But those people were able to point police in Foster's direction.
We've gotten some very good statements from all the people that were involved that's really helped out our investigations. Shortly after the officers were called here, it was also that we had a car that was a pickup truck that was stolen from right in this immediate neighborhood.
Police believe that Foster stole the pickup and fled the scene, prompting police to put out an alert warning that Foster was armed and dangerous. And after several hours, Foster turned himself in.
Thanks to Ray Brewer for that report. Foster is currently being booked at the Farmington Police Department. There's a possibility he'll be arraigned this afternoon on that attempted murder charge. And high bail for a Northfield man accused of selling drugs. 38-year-old Justin Gauthier was arrested Friday after a months-long investigation into drug trafficking. During a search of his home on Diana Drive, police discovered a hide in a child's room where they found money, meth, and heroin. They also discovered several guns. And divers are in the Pemigewasset River this afternoon for a man who drowned near New Hampton. Fish and Game say a husband and wife from Hudson were out in a small boat when the 54-year-old man tried to rescue one of his dogs on the river. The man went underwater. His body was recovered a short while ago in 8 feet of water. A Laconia man is accused of threatening people with a knife. 33-year-old Benjamin Fields was arrested after someone reported he was threatening people in the area of Jewett Street. One witness told police that Fields also had a hammer and possibly a gun. He's charged with 2 counts of criminal threatening. A Nashua woman is accused of driving drunk and not stopping for police. Haley Drew was allegedly going 78 miles per hour in a 40-mile-per-hour zone along Daniel Webster Highway Sunday morning. Police tried to pull her over, but she reportedly ran a red light and got onto the Everett Turnpike before finally stopping. Drew is charged with reckless driving, disobeying a police officer, and aggravated DWI. We still don't know what started a suspicious fire that left 19 people homeless in Manchester. The flames broke out late Saturday night at an apartment building on Spruce Street. Investigators believe the fire started on the first or second floor porch. When firefighters arrived, they heard people trapped inside and calling for help.
The intense heat of the occupants, their clothes were actually smoking when they were exiting the building. The ladder companies reported that they were coming down the stairwell and they thought they were on fire.
Fortunately, everyone got out of the building safely. The district fire chief says this was the most intense fire he's seen in his 34 years of service. Starting tonight at 5, a new partnership hopes to put a dent in Amazon sales, which online retailer has been bought by Walmart. And did you know much of the U.S. Olympic team's Rio fashion was made in New England? We'll take a closer look. That does it for us here on the web. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you later tonight.